Morning, everyone. So today I'm gonna do a scale tape lure. Got a Bandit, it's chrome. I've got my scale pattern, my scale tape from Barlow's. And I really was kind of hesitant to do a video on this, but when I started doing these, which is back in like, I don't know, 2018, I got a lot of questions on where I got it. So no problem, I got it from Barlow's. And the next thing I know, when I go to restock my supply, they're out of it. They eventually got it back in stock, so I'm all good and I'm all resupplied. But what I'm going to do today is one that I made this one the first time back in 2018, and I ran it in a tournament the next year. And on day one, that thing was just hotter than a pistol, and we ended up winning that tournament. And it was a fun weekend. Day two, they wouldn't touch crank, so we had to go to a different technique. But when my buddy Tony sees this video, if he sees it, he'll probably have a heart attack that I'm sharing this. So this is a stencil that I made, and this is some 20 mil plastic that you can find on eBay. I bought it years ago, so I don't like have a link to it or anything, but I know it's just 20 mil stencil plastic. And I originally bought it so you could form fit it over a bait, but that was a bust for me. So what I'm gonna do is cut out a couple of pieces of this tape. I like to have the scales, you know, pointing towards the head of the head of the bait. You're not gonna get but about two for a Bandit. You can get, it'll leave a little bit of tape on this card for other baits. Barlow's has got this tape in about six different colors. And the thing I really like about it is it's so thin. Hardly leaves any kind of a seam whatsoever. It will leave a seam, but it's just not too bad. Not too bad. I like to start at the tail, and yeah, you can touch the back of it. It won't mess with it too bad, and you can pick it up and you can put it on, take it off until you do this. Once you've done this, it's on there. If you have to pull it off for some reason, you just have to go and cut yourself another piece. Which, believe me, I've had to do a time or two. But it really seals down good. I've tried other tapes, and when you go to paint them, they're a little heavier, and you'll see the edges of the tape coming up and you get paint under it, you can't get them to fillet down. So I just flip this thing over and I can do the other side. Make sure you get it laid down on the tail end of that and right here around the gill. And you just feel it for little bumps. If you got any bumps, you can pretty much work them out. Every once in a while I'll get a crease, and depending on what I'm making it for, if I'm making it for myself, a lot of times leave it in there because I don't think the fish can tell the difference. And make it for somebody else and I'll pull it off and redo it. I got another one that I'm going to do, and I'll make a video on it maybe one of these days, but I'll use silver on this one, and I'll hit this with some kind of paint prior to putting that scale tape on, and pin it on the tape, the paint I mean. If you have to pull it off, sometimes it will pull that paint off. I generally use candies on something like that, and the candies, they adhere a lot better. So, turn this compressor back on. Createx illustration paint, Bloodline white. And so blend that steam in pretty well. Red is the, it's the same outfit. Korea Tech's illustrations. This is a blood red. Flows really, really nice. Cleans up really nice. You can see, maybe you can see, I didn't quite get them the same on both sides, which is pretty typical, but they're close. So now I'm going to take some golden high flow, dark violet. Again, I'll
what you doing?
I'll run this on about 15 or so. And I'm not gonna come all the way down. I'm gonna start about where that tape starts and just work towards the tail. Looks pretty sweet on chrome. So on the next step, I'm going to use some candy. I don't, typically use a bleed checker in my candies. I'm going to use a combination. I've got the emerald green and poison green with candy 2-0. I'll put about 4 to 5 drops. Poison. And just a couple of drops of the emerald. End up a lot of pain in my fingers. Mix it up. Back down to about 11. And just light coats. Just go over the seam of it. Where the scale tape meets the gills. I'll dry this. Hit it again. Couple of steps left of this thing. I'm gonna have to go grab a stencil out of my drawer. Take some candy 2-0 black. And this particular stencil is one that I got from Whitmore Farm. I was putting these on the longest time, you know, just one stripe at a time. I'd do here, and I'd do here, and then I'd get one in the middle, and then in the middle, and turn it over, and do. Oh, I'm not going to do that pattern, but I talked to Jeff at Whitmore, and asked him if he could, I showed him the pattern I liked and was running with, and asked him if he could build me a stencil, and he got right on it, and I see now that there's a few other guys out there using this stencil. Wipe that stencil off just to make sure you ain't got nothing on the residual paint on there. Jeff, he's made three or four different pencils for me now over the last few years. So I've got one more step I'm going to do. Dry it real quick first. Right here is some dragon glaze. You've got it, it's a glitter, and it comes in a variety of different colors. I've got, I don't know, probably half a dozen different colors up there. This one is 44380. And like I said, I got it at Hobby Lobby. You can put it on a couple different ways. I typically brush it on, but you can also spray it on. If you're going to spray it on, I recommend you use like a 0.5 gun as opposed to a 0.35. It's pretty thick. You will have to thin it if you spray it. And I've got a gun set up just so I can spray this crap on some others. But typically I like to brush it on. What I did find with this though is, like if you got a candy, but you're trying to brush it on, and it just smears that candy all over. Candy. So what I've been doing is just blotching it on. dip it out of the cap and it's a real, real fine glitter. I'll just do the purple. I'm gonna stay out of that green on the head. It'll mess it up if you get in there too much. And you can just let this thing air dry, or you can take heat to it. And this brush is the same brush I started with 4 or 5 years ago, so get some hot water, it'll wash right out. I don't know if you can tell glitter shows up this far from the camera or not, but it's definitely there. Anyway, that's it. One of my favorite lures. And I don't really make much money on weekend. Thanks for watching. I'll talk to you guys later.